welcome back to the channel. So tonight, kicking off the weekend with another cook, doing a pork scotch here for pulled pork. Got this little guy from Drake's supermarket. So get this one rubbed down and cooked up for the weekend. So just gonna pat it dry first, just to get all that excess moisture off. So we'll get it rubbed down, might as well start on this side. Bit of French's mustard. Alright, first base coat we're doing. Smoke chamber, all-purpose dust down. This one, to me, we call it in our house, the garlic bread rub, because it's got that garlic butteriness to it, a bit of salt and pepper as well. It's good as a base coat on anything really, but especially pork. Liberal coat of that. Then we're going on with two of my favorite pork rubs, Bulldozer Barbecue Hogfather and Bulldozer Barbecue Better Off Red, just for that color, for getting that deep mahogany color when we're smoking it. So we'll go on first with the Hogfather. Sprinkle it on from a nice height, just to get an even coverage on it there. Alright, so we'll pat that in. I like to keep this hand clean, keep my rub containers clean. And once that's all tacked up, we'll flip it over, and that's looking pretty good actually. That mustard as a bind has worked and done its magic. So all rubbed down now, got it on the baking tray, inside the foil tray here, just to catch any drippings or anything like that. It's going to go in the fridge and have to sleep until the wee hours of the morning. We'll light up the smoker. See you tomorrow. Alright, we're back at the shack and time to get this pork ready to go. But before we do, I'm just going to run through what I'm going to use today. So first off, we need briquettes. So I'm going to be using the olive pip briquettes there. Going to be lighting those up with a tumbleweed fire lighter, cigarette lighter of course. Topping that off with two types of wood, so we've got cherry wood and we've got jam wood here as well. So cherry wood will give it a nice colour and a bit of a subtle flavour, and that with a good combination with the jam wood. We've already rubbed it down with Better Off Red, Hogfather and Smoke Chamber All Purpose Dust Down. Then we'll be spritzing along the way with apple cider vinegar, and use Bragg's. Spritzing that down with a combination of half-half apple cider vinegar and water. We'll need a instant read thermometer. We'll need a pit thermometer, so I use Inkbird. You can have four different probes in there, but I'm just going to be using two today. One in the smoker for ambient temp, and the other for meat temp, to monitor that through the course of the cook. Then we'll be using the Oklahoma Joe today, the drum. So I'll show you how I set that up in a few minutes. And a charcoal chimney. Alright, so we've taken our pork scotch out of the fridge. Most people say not to season your meat overnight because the salt will draw the moisture out, and I get that. But I was actually quite interested to see, after this has sat in the fridge for... what time? About 8 o'clock last night. It's now 9:30 in the morning, so a good 12 hours this rub's been sitting on there. It actually hasn't dropped any moisture at all, really. So, yeah, found that pretty interesting. So I guess we'll get the smoker set up today to get this one cooked. I could use the Weber, that's not a problem. But I just find this drum's better for lower and slower cooks. So I'll run you through a bit of that and show you how we set it up. Okay, so I've got the Oklahoma Joe Bronco Pro here. So this is a 22-inch drum smoker. We'll get it all disassembled and I'll talk you through it. So it comes with one rack, not this one, just a standard rack with without the set of it that comes out. So we'll take these two racks out. You can actually put hanging racks in this as well. That's what these three spots are for, so you can hang chalks, ribs, things like that. I haven't done that yet, but that might be something to look out for in the future. Then we've got our baffle plate or heat deflector. We'll take that one out. Our basket for all the briquettes or lump charcoal. And the ash pan. On the side, we have got our inlet. So this one here is adjustable, like most of them are, but it actually gives you gradients, which is handy. And then we've got our top exhaust port as well, exactly the same setup. All right, so we'll get some pips lit up and get this bad boy started. Alright, so as I said before, I'll be using the Olive Co. briquettes. These are a natural product, and the reason I like to use these is, one, they're a sustainable product. Two, made from all natural products, so there's no nasties in there, no chemicals, anything like that. And yeah, you get a cleaner cook, cleaner burn, and a long burn as well. So I'll get the chimney started up and get some on. Alright, so I've got a 10 kilo bag here that's probably about half full, so I'll chip that in. This thing holds about 8 to 10 kilos of these, depending if I pack stacking easily or not. And I'll generally speaking get about a 20-hour burn from this, so it's a really efficient cooker. Alright, and the rest of it we'll just fill up with bit pips. Just get some started up in the chimney. And as you can see from the size of them, they're not huge, but they're quality. And they look like little UFOs. All right, so we'll get the tumbleweed lit up now. I like to use these as, again, they're a natural product. I know I'm not cooking with this, but I don't want any chemicals getting into the flavor of these pips or into the meat in turn as well. So we'll get that lit up. And get that underneath the chimney and get things started up. So we're back out at the smoke shack. We've got these pips burning and they're almost all ashed over. What I do notice from these is, one, you don't get much smoke coming off of them, and two, they emit a really sweet smell. So it's not like you're getting a chemical smell from all additives in there trying to keep them lit up. These things don't need any of that. They've literally taken about 10 minutes to get those lit up. I haven't got heaps of them, but I would think with a full chimney you're probably looking about 30 minutes. So we'll get those tipped in to the drum basket. I would usually do this in the drum, but just for so you guys can see how I do this, we'll load it up in the ground. We'll reassemble this drum now. So we've got the ash pan that sits at the bottom. Then we'll load up the pips into there, into the drum basket. And even for a short guy like me, this drum's pretty easy to load up. Then the heat deflector. That goes in just over the top of that. Some drums use a water pan. This one doesn't. I think it works out just as good. Alright, so we'll close the smoker up now. Make sure that top and bottom vent are wide open. Let this thing come up to temp. Alright, so we're getting close to the temperature that we're shooting for today. We're going to be aiming for around 250. I never trust the analog gauges on these, so we'll put our ambient temp sensor probe in a short second. So I'll take out the deflector plate. Probably shouldn't put that in that early. Just take that out. Alright, now we put the smoking wood on. So like I was saying before, I've got the cherry wood and jam wood to use today. I think this would be a good flavour profile on this and a good combo of smoking woods. And you'll find links in my description for everything that I buy, but literally everything that I've shown you that I'm going to be using today, I've purchased from the Smoking Log Co. They sell absolutely everything barbecue related there. Accessories, cooking gear, rubs, sauces, knives, smoking woods of all different types. Probably the largest range in Australia, I would say. So we'll get this assembled back up now and get a heat deflector plate in. Bottom cooking rack in. Then an aluminium tray just to sit underneath the meat to catch all the drippings. Top rack. Ambient temperature probe. And because we are cooking for home today and I've run out, no gloves today, so I'll just pop this in. And close the smoker. So we'll close this down. At this stage, I've still got both the vents wide open, but as the temperature comes up, I'm going to start slowly trimming those back so that we can get the temperature we want. I'll start shutting them down a bit prematurely because it's easier to bring the heat up than bring the heat down. So I'll bring that down to 2 on the bottom one, but I always keep the top wide open. And as you can see, we've got smoke rolling there now, so we're started cooking. Alright, so we're getting close to our desired temperature of 250 degrees Fahrenheit. What I'm going to start doing now is shutting down these vents. So keep the top vent open, but then we'll trim back the intake vent to about a quarter of the way open. Alright, so let's have a little bit of a look at this now. It's been on about an hour and a half. Sitting on 247, still got those vents closed up, so we've got about a quarter open on the intake vent, wide open on the exhaust, and you can see that smoke's just coming out thin blue, which is exactly what we want. So I'll have a quick sneaky peek at this one, and as you can see, that's smoking along nicely. We'll give it a bit of a spritz down now. So we've got 50-50 mix in the spritz bottle here of apple cider vinegar. I use Bragg's and water. Alright, then we'll close that back up and let it keep cooking. Alright, so we're back out at the smoker now, getting the temp right where we want it at 250 degrees. The pulled pork, or the pork scotch rather, is at around 165. So we're going to get this taken out now, get it pushed through the stall, wrap it up in some alfoil, and put it back in. Heavy duty aluminium foil, we're going to double wrap it. Put it back in the smoker. Put that probe back in. And get it up to 205 degrees. Alright, so final stages now. It's all up to 205. Smoker sat on 250 degrees Fahrenheit consistently throughout the cook. Now it's time to get this out. Probe temp at first. Not so much for the temperature, but just for the feel. And it should feel like a knife going through warm butter, which there is no resistance at all apart from the alfoil. So we'll get this off the smoker, get it inside, rest it up, and see how we went. All right, so we brought the pork scotch inside. Now time for the big reveal and just to let it steam off for about 15 minutes just to stop that cooking process. Looking pretty good to me, so we'll let that steam off for a bit, let it cool down,
and then we'll start to pull them. All right, so we've let it rest. Now it's time to get it out and get it sliced up. No need for that. When you got pork this tender, you don't need a knife. All right, so old mate Michael Jackson, he's only got one glove, so we're just gonna get this all pulled down with one hand. Asbestos fingers are pretty good, but they're not that good. This is piping hot. So as you can see, the smoke's penetrated that nicely. It's a nice pink hue to the meat, meaning that smoke has penetrated quite well into this cut. All right, so we're just gonna season this meat again now, just to get those bits that obviously didn't get the rub on them while it was cooking. So we'll get that on there. Once again, using the Bulldozer Barbecue Hog Father, get that mixed through. As you can see, this meat is just fall apart tender. All right, so now that that's mixed through, we're gonna get the Bulldozer Barbecue Peppered Pineapple on there and get this all sauced up. All right, we'll get that mixed through. The smells from this are incredible. All right, and we'll transfer this to a serving board. All right, so we've let this pulled pork cool now for a little bit. So we're gonna have a bit of a taste test now and see what we think. Melt in your mouth. The first flavors that I get are from those rubs. Sweet, savory, little bit of heat to them. Followed up by that smoke created from jam wood and the cherry there. Got a great color on this one, and we can use this in heaps of different ways. So we'll do pulled pork quesadillas, we'll do loaded fries, sliders, you name it, you can use this. It's down to your imagination as to how you want to do it. So we'll get this all served up now, have dinner. Have a great weekend, guys. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel, and we'll see you next time. Cheers.